Hello, everybody. This is the M Crew Dude. I don't even know why Sony even bothered making another open season. They completely lost touch with their audience at this point, so I have to wonder who they even thought this movie was for. If you're unfamiliar with the series at this point, open season started off with a decent first movie in 2006 involving a domestic grizzly bear who saves the forest from a gang of hunters, while one in particular just wants to murder everything for sport. The second movie came out in 2008 and just had everyone complain a lot while trying to save a bland side character from a deranged poodle who got traumatized after being scared by a bird. Now we have Open Season 3 released in 2010, which has nothing to do with hunting and just centers around a circus.
What kind of uninteresting plot has Sony cooked up for this film? Well, I'll tell ya, and it's probably not as interesting as you're thinking.
The film opens as the studio logo runs in like it's on crack, followed by a painful reminder of the agony I just endured.
Already we're off to a glowing start.
So Boog wakes up from his winter hibernation and plans to invite his friends to go on an all-dudes vacation. He finds that Riley the Beaver is unable to come with, so he talks to McSquizzy to help him collect his nuts. Funny how he threw a lot of them into the air when only a few of them came back down. Let that set the stage for the type of movie we're in for. It's also worth mentioning that both Boog and Elliot's voice actors have changed yet again, and now they sound even stupider somehow. Matthew J. Munn now voices Boog, and Elliot is voiced by Maddie Taylor, who was the one who actually voiced Ian in Open Season 2, but still reprises her roles as Denny and Buddy since the first movie. Even McSquizzy's voice has changed. He's now voiced by Andre Soguliso, who's also known for roles such as Sparks the Dragonfly from some of the Spyro games, Ace Hardlight from Ratchet Deadlocked, and the Khajiit voice from Skyrim. Anyways, Boog finds that none of his friends are able to go with him, and then he comes across Elliot, who's busy abusing rabbits with his three ugly children. Just as another example of how out of touch this movie is, Elliot makes a reference to Pogs, as if anybody watching this film is gonna know what that is. So Elliot agrees to Boog's guy's trip right before Giselle, his fat-ass wife, reminds him that he has to babysit, something that he agreed to do 2 weeks prior. Does this moron ever change? He also complains that Giselle is off to visit her monstrous mother, someone who Elliot despises but the viewer has no context for. So Boog resorts to going on the trip alone and talks to his stuffed bear Dinkelman, who is strangely absent from the last movie. Have you ever been so pathetic that you had to take your plushie on vacation as your friend? So Boog ends up not having the best of times, and decides to break into a gas station store which was rebuilt after it blew up in the last movie, and he helps himself to the chocolate bars. After getting drunk off chocolate, no seriously, he makes a joke about it.
Don't worry, nobody's driving.
He then starts objectifying this poor rabbit.
This is the best guy's trip ever.
Man, Dinkelman agreed with you 100%.
Rabbit loves Dinkelman. Dinkelman loves rabbit.
I can't even laugh at this, it's just pathetic. As Boog complains some more, he spots a poster for a traveling circus and follows the lights into the forest. As he explores the circus tent, literally set up in the middle of nowhere, he comes across another grizzly bear named Doug, also voiced by Munn, and his annoying spitting llama friend named Alistair, voiced by Dana Snyder. Doug explains to Boog that they could trade places for a day so that the circus doesn't suspect anything, even though Boog somehow thinks that they're going to be best friends. Yeah, the reasoning behind this is never made clear. In reality, Doug just wants to leave so that he can be worshipped by the other animals.
I mean, back where I came from?
I know, the zoo.
No. For the last time, it's the wild animal park. There's a difference, you know? Anyway, when I was in the wild animal park, no one treated me like that. All the animals worshipped me. There was one grizzly, one king of the jungle, me.
Oh, see?
Just when you thought this movie couldn't get any more idiotic, we then cut to the trailer park where Mr. Weenie and company are staying at. Why did we need to bring these characters back? Their arc is over. They now just exist to artificially extend the runtime. At least we get to see Roger again, and as we all know, Roger makes everything better.
Oh, thank you for it. Why?
Unfortunately, we also have to put up with Fifi for no reason. This time, he has a pink donut on his ass because he got neutered in between films. He may have lost his balls, but he still finds comfort in playing with them in his paw. The two southern dogs don't make a return, but instead we have this sheepdog named Nate. And he never does anything useful or ever says anything, so he's just a complete waste of animation. So Fifi and Mr. Weenie sit by the television and watch a commercial for the circus which features Doug. Of course, they suddenly think that Boog is in trouble, and they decide to venture off to get an explanation. For some reason, Fifi wants to help rescue him despite wanting to kill him in the last movie. I guess losing his balls also caused him to lose his memory. The next morning, Boog wakes up and meets with some female Russian bear so he can rehearse some act that he knows nothing about. Of course, Boog messes up and causes the rehearsal to shut down for the day. In hindsight, it really wasn't clear why he thought the circus was an ideal place to begin with, so I guess he just wanted to stare at some thick bear ass. Come on, he can do that at home since he has access to a 3D entertainment system from Sony. As the real Doug ventures into the forest, he comes across Riley's dam and meets Boog's friends, who quickly notice that something is different. As Elliot confronts him, he demands an apology despite the fact that he was in the wrong to begin with. At this point, I'd be more surprised if he actually took responsibility for once. As Boog is left without any sign of Doug, Alistair admits that the whole plan was just a lie so that Doug could jump ship. You mean that's something he couldn't have admitted to sooner? He must have known that Doug's plan was to leave him behind as well, so it seems that Doug is just some selfish jerk who betrayed both of them for his own benefit. After Alistair sings some annoying song about his ex-girlfriend for no reason, Boog starts to ogle the Russian bear's thick ass again. And then he tries to explain his situation, but she decides not to believe him despite the fact that he's no longer disguised as Doug. Following that, we get this rather confusing line.
You twanged?
No.
Okay, 'cause I thought I heard my name.
What?
Meanwhile, Roberto the Basset Hound tracks Boog sent to the gas station as they ride a truck full of circus supplies. Fifi then loses his balls for the second time, which flatten under the wheel of a truck like jelly beans. The pets then grab a circus poster from inside the store, and then Roger swallows it because he thought it was beef jerky. I'm sorry, but it's impossible for me to hate this character. So Boog manages to convince the Russian bear that he was telling the truth, and the two of them hit it off unusually well because Boog can actually perform juggling acts, which is something Doug was too pathetic to do. I mean, there is some attention to detail given Boog's past as a sideshow attraction, but it would have been a lot nicer if the film took these opportunities to give the characters better arcs. Speaking of bad characters, Doug is busy turning the other animals into his personal slaves until Giselle returns, and only now does everyone realize that Doug has been replaced. Well, everyone except for Elliot, but he's special. Doug then reveals that the circus will return for Russia soon, taking Boog with them, but he refused to tell him where the tent is, so the animals sit on his face and paddle him for information. Upon following the beams of light, Elliot and the other animals arrive at the circus along with the pets, who just so happen to see them too, meaning that it was right next to them from the beginning. I hate this. After the team meets up, Elliot's daughter, voiced by Ciara Bravo, comes up with a plan to enter the tent because we can't have an adult come up with something that makes sense, and no one seems to notice a bunch of furries in the stands as they wander around. So Mr. Weenie gets shoved into a cannon and shot into orbit for some reason, and then Fifi's fur gets set on fire only to have another dog piss on his head to put it out. Good lord! No wonder they're off the grid. Peta would burn this place to the ground. As Boog and Elliot eventually find each other, Boog is rushed on stage, and we get a slight glitch in the animation right here. Oh. I have no idea why no one saw that or how it even got through editing. Boog manages to finish the performance with the bear, whose name is Ursa, by the way, and then Doug comes back to finish the show with Alistair. Ursa now agrees to live with Boog in the forest, despite claiming that the circus was her home, which doesn't make much sense. You'd think that Boog would want to be with the circus since he's better at being a performer than a wild animal, but no. In fact, Elliot was even okay with letting Boog leave for Russia knowing that it could make him happy. The one time he shows genuine growth as a character, it's completely thrown out the window.
Let them go.
But the circus!
The circus will be fine.
What? How do they know what's going on? Whatever, it's almost over. So they return to the forest where Ursa allows Boog to finally go on his guy's trip.
Dinkleman, I didn't know you were a girl.
Either that or you helped awaken his fetish. So the guys head off, except for Ian, who embraces his new life as a birthday stripper. Finally, the movie's over. Wait a sec.
Who's up for a happy life?
No! No! It said the end! That's it! Okay, now it's over.
Okay, everybody. I have a little surprise. Now close your eyes. When you hear these words, what do you think of? Excitement? Amazing? Fantastico?
Watching literally any other movie?
I'm talking about a slideshow!
That's your idea of fun? Seriously, this stupid presentation goes on for the rest of the credits. All it is a bunch of pictures with characters poorly cropped into various backgrounds.
And now it's finally over. I have to say that this is easily the worst one in the series, with its poor pacing, pointless characters, conflicted morals, and consistently terrible animation.
Unlike the second movie, the plot was very drawn out and had too much needless crap which distracted from the storyline. Overall, the biggest problem is that this movie is relentlessly boring at times. It failed to hold my attention for very long due to how unlikable the characters are and the dull color palette. Most of the issues I had with the second film return here, but there is absolutely no redeeming quality. I doubt kids will get much enjoyment out of it, so it would be better off forgotten. I honestly thought Madagascar 3 had a better storyline than this, so I would suggest that instead. But hey, at least we get to see Roger one last time, so that's something, I guess.
This is the M Crew Dude, signing off, wishing you all a very pleasant day.